My name is Minhyea. I'm from the University of Florida, the border. I really thank you for the organizer to give the opportunity to talk about our work. Since this is the last talk of the session, I just want to show you some of the our earlier work in the same right thermal conductivity. So our research is like four thermal conductivity in plane field and longitudinal thermal conductivity. We just see really amazing work from the thermal hall effect. I'm telling you that measurement is really, really hard to measure. So it's really, So before I go on, I want to thank first some very hardworking my two students. So all the data showing is taken by Chris and Ian. And my sample of the lithium trichloride comes from the South Korea collaboration with Professor Choi in Chung University. And Long is our local colleague, and we've been like working a lot together, or trying to work a lot together in the early days. And the new measurement of the thermal conductivity and magnetic torque was not possible without help from the measure of magnetic field lab physicist named Ed Kinsong. So I really want to thank them first. So my talk outline is again, this is the last talk of the session. I just want to go over the basic discrete quantity of the lithium trichloride, which is like really one representative material of the Kitaev physics candidate. And then thermal conductivity under in-plane field, as I said. And then a characteristic of the magnetic torque, which is like relatively less, received less attention in studying this new resilient quantum magnet system. And particularly, I will actually show this peak and dip structure, which we still actually have a low antibody, frankly speaking. We're trying to get some more data on this, but we're showing some work on the sodium trichloride and sodium iridate once we do the original type of material. And then, since these data are very complicated, we try to go on some much simpler magnet, which is like chromium trichloride, which is isomorphic structure with the sodium trichloride. But I should have known that in physics, there's like no simpler model. They always another interesting story coming out of it. So, summarizing it, that this is like numbers, this is pulled by the sodium iridate has a complicated probe data. In fact, this peak and dip structure is happening much higher field. Sodium trichloride is like supposed to be a simpler system, and yet, that's covering lots of interesting field methods. And once we understand this, I think we might go back there. So first, the lithium trichloride is octahedron from the two-dimensional this famous honeycomb lattice, and then the structure distortion in the plane is like much minimal compared to sodium iridate. So you immediately take the occasion to realize the quasi-2D system. And then it also has some structural transition around the quadrant coming from one plane to longer fibra. And then the zigzag ordering is happening around 6 to 7 Kelvin. Our sample here we're showing is like transient temperatures around 6.5 Kelvin. And again, as Professor Matsuda said, depending on the stacking property, the TC is like varying different varies between 7 to 14 Kelvin. And that already tells you that such a subtle stacking difference is like giving you a large variation of the P nail. Already tells you that it's very fragile of low range order they have. And then so this is like the typical model. I mean, I'm an experimentalist, so I try to keep it as simple as possible. So the Heisenberg spectrum, and then this old diagram interaction comes. And then under the field actually introduced this seemingly simple-looking Zeeman pump, but as we've seen all day yesterday and even today, there's like so many interesting phenomena that the field is like covering. And I intentionally didn't include any reference here. There's like too many of them. So this is like one of the early data of the large field versus magnetization data up to 60 tesla, and this is like out of plane field, and this is in plane field. And keep going on. And then on the other hand, when you apply field out of plane, your negative moments are almost like, you know, just fixed on the one out of in-plane field. That makes that any plane is negative because ETX is plane. And then so there's a little indication at all if you look at just the magnetic there's like some peak here if you take the derivative of EMPH. And that was like the very minute indication of the there's like some possible transition might be possible. Then before I go on, I just want to show you the first phase diagram that we construct purely based on the data. So this is like power plot, just the raw data, use the raw data from the magnetic torque, which I'm going to explain in like three after slide. So this is like TNL, x-axis is like magnetic field, and y-axis is like temperature, and critical temperature is over here. So the measurement of the magnetic torque is done at the fixed temperature and sweep the field. And then if you actually roll field, if you sweep the field, the arc is roll number, bright color is a high number. So in fact, the torque is like very non-putting, dark, bright, and then dark again, and then become a little futuristic. And then that phenomenon is like disappearing once you go up, you see, it's a kind of more or less rotating behavior. So in fact, on top of the, so this is like, I didn't do anything, and as you might notice, we don't have a close to zero field data here. That's because in order to get the torque magnetization, you have to divide by H, and that kind of gives you diversity. So that's why my field is here truncated. And this is more data. So on top of that, if I add in, so the, actually you go to the 2D plot, see the minimum, that's what the boundary is. And then on top of that, we can add in Hmin, which is referred from the thermal conductivity as function of field. Thermal conductivity always has a minimum, and then that location is actually corresponding to this. And then naturally, in you three different reasons. Reason one is, as everybody knows, it's like now low range order. And reason two in high temperature reason. And high temperature reason three, low temperature reason three. So this data is naturally divided in the phase diagram in this way. So how can we get this? So the first thing is that low temperature thermal conductivity, that's already because much special case. And then again, we are only have a in-plane field, and our gradient and field is like parallel, both are in in-plane. And sample one and sample two, they both definitely have some sample tensors in this case. And then you can clearly see there's like some, you can identify from the thermal conductivity where the key nail is, that's what I'm saying. And if I go up here, it actually show up like little increase. And then this increase upon the magnetic ordering is relatively common in low the form of magnet. That's typically understood as like some phonon conductivity might be get better once the magnetic order gets sets in, then they kind of less together. And that already tells that about here is like already very much impacted by magnetic scattering. So like about this high temperature just cannot be phonon. Okay, responding to this. And then similarly, temperature has a similar behavior, just the high field reason is like that's more muted. And then if you, what Malamasy noticed is that fixed temperature, if you increase the field, again, sort of the field dependence is like not normal. And so that's actually more lines coming up here. And then that's how I actually come up with here, the field dependence of the solar conductivity at 2.5, and this bar is corresponding to delta kappa, which is like kappa h minus kappa naught, and that is like basically 100% change. Okay? So by the time you hit the minimum, it actually about 70% reduced. And then once you go up, solar conductivity really starts shooting up. And then if you go higher temperature, that trend is like always remaining. And then minimum is like slightly moving lower temperature, which is consistent with the Fukushima's data. And then that's actually going up, and then we actually test the TC now. However, this minimum is like still remaining. And in fact, if you go 20 Kelvin, that's actually outside of the window of our magnetic field. Okay? And then that's the pH minimum that I plot overlay across the plot. And then that's how we construct it. not just the majority is like not photon, in fact something else. So in the end, our paper was invoking some new excitations required to kind of enhance this much of thermal conductivity. There can be many other reasons. A lot of many people over here reported actually gap state, and how that exactly enhance thermal conductivity is like there's like many different interpretations. But our mind is okay, thermal conductivity is increasing very sharply. And that's the one thing we want to keep in mind when we look at the sodium uridate data. Which is not there. So now, magnetic type measurement is like, just I'm going to walk over how the sample is working. So this pink is the our single crystal sample, and then that's the actually any plane is like out of this plane. And then, so this is like a cantilever, and this is like ground plane. It will basically have a plane four coming out of the kind of thing. And then you measure capacitor between the cantilever and ground plane. So then if you depend on the magnetization, since it's EG plane, then fluoride light sample, magnetization is like sitting in plane, so torque will be this pressure, and then they will apply force of the plane, and then they give you changing of the capacitor. And out of field location is sample is a line as a C-axis out of the plane of the cantilever plane, and then field is like located in that direction. Here, field is located in y direction. And then torque is as we learned in the first physics 101. This is the M equals H, and that's corresponding. We're only R is R vector physics, so we only measure the F that's reflected in the changing of the capacitor. And magnetic torque magnetization is simply defined by tau divided by h. Okay? And then more the angular dependence is like characterized as a property of that sample, and then location it will be short. So that's what we the board of club and I heard the torque magnetization, that's actually in fact instead of tau, we're actually using the delta c divided by h. So in fact, it's an easy plane. Easy plane is a magnetic easy plane. So out of plane location is relatively easy to understand because magnetization always like magnetic plane. So in fact, this point is like when H is like parallel to AB, and then you apply large field, very tiny field by becoming out of the plane, and that's the minimum. So it has a 90 degree symmetry because of this sample geometry, the easy plane. On the other hand, also, then you actually measure the H dependence of the torque. So this is like basically torque. And then these black dots are what we measure in the squid magnetometer at home. And then we just using the one scalar factor, just the multiply by the entire data set, and then that actually gives you pretty consistent data with the Kubota published data from my quartile. That's actually, so any plane, CX out of plane location basically measured what average in plane magnetization, that's what we measure also in the magnetometer. On the other hand, in plane location is like kind of really surprising because it actually has a 90 degree, it actually has a two-fold symmetry, which is more or less consistent with. Monoclinic or monohydrate has actually square like transition. So that's how we actually understood this. And we do have a, so like this a field, so this is like this angular sweep and the fixed field. And then, so that's the whole data is identified at 1.7. So using this, we actually go near the close to small torque area, and then we do the field sweep now. So that's what we're showing here. So now we actually go step out once to fixed angle and then sweep the field. And then you can see that there's like a little peak and dip structure right at the near the field inclusion transition. And then you can increase. So when the first thing is, it's like, oh, this must be something screwed up in our setup. But if you increase the temperature and they're still pretty persistent, very easy to locate. But then as soon as you go above the TC, that feature is like, once you go above TC, this core value becomes really small. Okay. So then that's how we actually magnetism fully still weak because temperature is very low. But so that's why you can see the next patient's action much more clearly qualitatively speaking. And then this high temperature region, now phonon contribution got much more stronger. So your this new next patient effect is like washed out, but still remain up to pretty high temperature. If we have a higher resolution, this will continue to keep going up. Higher fields will continue to go up, and in fact, actually showing up at a very shallow anyway. On the other hand, we really don't have much of a handle about how to describe this peak and dip structure in magnetic torque area, magnetic torque data. So that's how we actually move to some other system, whether that's some group in a ruthenium trichloride or not. So first what we did was the conductivity data, and conductivity has like twice higher nail temperature. So we kind of thinking they might be the bigger field. So in fact, if you measure the conductivity with 14 tesla, conductivity is just the deep region and pretty much the same. And this is the same for the heat capacity as well. Up to 18 tesla, heat capacity does not change in, you know, maybe like at the most like several percent reduced. And then in fact, this is actually reduced. That's where the ruthenium trichloride originally starts. If you measure the, you look at the field dependent conductivity start decreasing. Okay? But we have not a higher field that is. On the other hand, we start measuring the torque magnetometry, but it's really interesting to see whether there's a field-induced transition. So in fact, we start seeing some particular angle, you start seeing this like nonlinear behavior again. Okay? So they are very boring, up to 20 tesla. And then just above the 25 tesla, there are certain particular angle of this nonlinear start showing up. And then in fact, this is like, again, angle dependence of the torque, and then curve I'm showing is like here and here, and then if I go further, this is like four curve, and then the nonlinear curve if I mark in the angular dependence. So this point is like more or less the same point. So 1, 2, 3 about speed point is like showing up here. So we're really excited because at that time we only have 31 tesla access, so I'm ready to write in like 25 tesla proposer, but we actually also. So this is actually color plus, this is like low field region, there's just a monotonic boring dependence. And then if you go 30 tesla, angle dependence is like really monotonic. And we try to fit this with a like vertical harmonics of that sign, but it actually did not work very well. It's not an issue. So what was ready to solve is to go to the higher field, but we in fact actually see the actually 2 weeks after we got this data. Paper was appeared in the archive. That's why Cambridge group, and in fact they did go all the way to city tesla, save our work. And they in fact see this like peak and dip phenomena. And they did a really calculation by transforming the footnote from the cantilever all the way up to the iridium atom. And then this wiggly behavior can be captured if you actually put it in the third up to the third unit. Okay. But however, here, just in terms of the big picture point of view, I cannot help but ask a question such as, so is this like really signature of the field-induced transition or not? Okay. Only difference is like this peak dip is like not very tight, it's very spread out. And is that really beyond like 60 tesla, if we ever get access to the, will it be a disorder state as and then we're kind of wondering whether this will be showing another highly enhanced form of connectivity. So in fact, we're actually going to take this data later next month. Okay, and then just a quick about that, because this is a supposed to be simple system. Okay, what I mean by simple is this like chromium trichloride has a pretty very similar crystal structure. Still need a more defined one. And similar phase spread structure, phase transition, and AP plan is like much more layered than ruthenium trichloride. And then it has this type 8 antiparabolic transition, and has cycle or usual half high cycle temperature. And then we notice that if you measure specific heat, there's a transition temperature, maybe it's 14 Kelvin, and then there's a 17 Kelvin little transition. We don't know exactly what that is. And then this is what I think is simple. The purely rise temperature from the beginning of the water high is like 10 to 25, it's not that low from the actual smoldering temperature. Effective magnetic moments are 4, the saturated moment is like 2.8. If you think of a single ion, it's like 3.8. So that's very close. And then these are also typical magnetic curve you often see. And if you apply spin out of plane, supposed to be hard as this. And if you correct the demand correction, these curves are pretty much on top of each other. So by the field of a Tesla, you can locate it anywhere. Okay? So this is like some of the theory of the chromium trichloride. The reason we study this is like we really want to understand how magnetic ordering actually interacting with the phone mode and then in simple system, and then we can model it or not. And this is routine trichloride, and chromium that is like much larger. Then if you, so this is your field. And then if you increase in field, this will be larger, larger, larger. 18 Tesla, much higher. And it's actually just above TC. That's what TC was the 14 Kelvin. And then surprisingly, actually, 18 Tesla will give you like nice TQ behavior, which we can assume that this might be coming from the phonon. But 0 Tesla is like much more contaminated. And then you can compare the field dependence. This is like the striking thing with the chromium, and this is the thin trichloride. And in fact, this like slight increase really inferring that your magnum existing magnum is actually carrying heat, and then they as applied field they got stiffened, so the magnum transfer velocity got really fast. And so again, this is like one of the typical field dependence you see in the low temperature magnetic system. But the field dependence is like always relatively weak, and but close to TC, this is like really enhanced a lot, which is like very similar if you think about the magnetic resistance, always get bigger and you largest when you get to the near the TC. And then above TC is kind of get smaller. So this data is like we kind of using it as a text, like how to look at the low temperature of thermal conductivity and interaction with the magnetic order of this geophysics. So for summary, the talk I started with is like how we search for the forms in liquid based on Kitaev spin model, but that's kind of how we can move forward to the theory as experimental with tangible measurement between the different measurements make a connection with each other. So these are the conditions we keep already talk about a lot. And then we can actually try to, most of it, in case that we present of the long-range order, we try to drive the system out of the solar state. And then we kind of looking for the, again, our strategy is like for the magnetic core and see whether there's like unusual magnetic field dependence. But before that, we have to really understand how the phonon will interfere with us. And then how complex change under such field in this space, and then that how impact, or how can we take care of the impact from the phonon? That will be the big problem for us. And then again, focus on the data is really awesome, and we're going to try to work hard to get some data. Okay, so for that, I will thank you for your attention.
Comment, Dr. Lukanen.
Yeah, their integer will be bound in us.
But the interpretation is precise. All the precise will take this private sector and take into account the GPO of this game.
Just a quick question on that graph that you had on your last slide. Delta kappa in field, is that kappa in field minus kappa?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.